Howdy, howdy, everybody. Welcome to HT's EDC, coming at you from the back patio. And we have co-host
Miss Abby right here. She is in her spot.
And she's a little laser focused right now. We got a old tree rat just off camera here in the woods behind my house that's making all kind of a ruckus up here in one of these pine trees. And Miss Abby is checking that squirrel out and pretty well laser focused on what's going on over there. But yeah, she is kind of neglecting her co-host duties at the moment, but nevertheless, today we have a traveling knife that we're going to look at. And this one came to me from Brother Mike Cornbread, as you guys know him, with the Hunting for Hookers channel. Awesome channel, buddy. You're hilarious. A lot of great content. Shout out to Hunting for Hookers. If you're watching me, you by far are already watching Brother Mike. But anyway, Mike was the one that sent it down to me. And first of all, before we get off into it, Mike sent me a few things. And I got to say thank you real quick. I'm not going to embarrass you, Mike. Sent me this nice bandana, a nice orange. We got, of course, we have the theme going on from Mike. He is staunchly one of those fellas of the orange. He sent me a nice Mora knife here that he has done some mods. Got me a ferro rod built in here. Cool lanyard. Nice, wrapped in this nice orange bandana. And of course, we got a letter from you, Brother Mike. Of course, we're not going to read it. I read it. And man, thank you so much for this. Thank you for the kind words in the letter toward my channel. Salute, brother. Thank you very much. So, wanted to get that out of the way. And something else that came in the pack. We always have a swag pack, a sticker logo pass around, and it's kind of on the honor system. If you don't have some of these folks that this knife's been to, if you don't have one of their stickers already and you want to take a sticker out, I think that's totally okay. You always want to put something, you know, I always put something back in. This is my stack right here that's going back in. We have an HT, I'm dropping them, but we have an HT, bear with me, channel sticker that's going back in there, one of mine, and I just have a whole litany here of some swag, and there's more swag and channel stickers in this thing. Folks, it's just like on the honor system. If you don't have somebody's logo or channel sticker and you need it, you want it, pull it out, drop one of yours in. If you think some of this swag is cool, you know, you want to put some of this, any of these stickers speak to you, take them out, drop a couple in. It's no big deal. Don't overthink it. It's on the honor system. But this is all going in here. So that is nice and sealed. And we'll be going now to the next recipient. Okay, quick drink of the interwebs coolest coffee cup, by the way. Just saying. Before we get into the star of the show, this was sent along in the box. And via email, I've talked to Brother Mike. He don't know who put it in there. This was not the original, this isn't the pass around knife, but someone has put this knife in there. I guess to get our thoughts, I suppose if somebody wanted it, I don't know. I don't want to speak out of turn on this. I don't know if this is a gift for anybody that, like, if this knife spoke to you, that you could take it out, put one in. That is my assumption. It was just like a donation to the whole thing. If you love it, it speaks to you, take it out, put one in. Don't know that. Mike didn't really know. I don't know, but I'm going to give you my brief thoughts on it. We'll look at the sheath here real quick. Has some pretty cool scroll work on it. not bad. Stitching. Stitching leaves a little to be desired, but folks, this is a Rough Rider knife. And check this out, got the matching lanyard here and lanyard bead to go with this, kind of bluish turquoise looking deal here. And this is Rough Rider 2591 from Pakistan. Come around here, we see Rough Rider. And I would call this just a medium size hunting knife. And folks, I keep it real on this channel. For me, this just don't speak to me. It doesn't. This is not something that I personally would buy. The edges are kind of sharp. It's honestly kind of a rudimentary, rough finish on this guy. Blade grinds are not bad. Do I think this will function as a knife? Actually, those blade grinds are pretty even. Kudos on the blade grind. It's a little sharp in hand. I don't know. It just, folks, for me, this is not something that I would look for in my outdoor knife. But I would call this, you know, kind of a companion knife. If it does speak to you, it's definitely not a large knife. It's kind of on the borderline of being a little big and broad for my taste as an EDC knife. But I would say this would be a good companion knife, you know, paired with a bigger knife for the feel. But just in hand, it just doesn't do it for me, folks. I will not be pulling this knife out, so this will be definitely getting passed on for me to the next person. But it's not, I've seen worse, folks. This one just does not particularly speak to me, but it may speak to the next person. Like I say, if somebody probably, I don't want to speak out of turn, but I'm guessing this was kind of a toss-in knife for someone that if you liked it, you could pull it out and put one of your own in there. I don't know. I won't be doing that because it just don't trip my trigger. But anyway, that's my thought on this. A decent companion knife. Again, kind of sharp edges. Not my color. Not exactly my favorite blade shape, how they've done the blade. Just, it's a pass for HD. So, moving on, that will go back into the box to the next recipient after me. The Rough Rider, what was that, 2591? Yes, Rough Rider 2591. If somebody's interested in this, this does speak to you. RR 2591 will get you in this thing right here. Moving on. What we did come to see, the traveling knife. First of all, we're going to show you the case it comes in. Nice Victorinox sheath here. It is Velcro. Personally, I would like to see a snap there. But if you're going to do Velcro, do it well. And that has pretty good retention. Again, I'm a snap guy. I feel more confident. Especially in the field, something just catching that, snagging that, you could say that's personal preference, but it's not easy. It ain't just, it takes some doing to get it off. So for Velcro, it's well executed. And I love this little logo. That is pretty cool. It's almost kind of a brushed satin, finish, almost light, kind of pewterish on the shield on there. I do like that. I think aesthetically that's a cool little emblem on there, and I like that. Well done. But that's what this is housed in. Does have a belt loop, obviously, so about this much is going to stick up. Another personal preference, that's not too bad. So it would be on your belt, about that much, about to where the rivets is standing above your belt, about an inch. On my side sheaths, I'm pretty particular. I'm a side sheath guy, and I like to see those up there higher. I like a kind of a low ride belt sheath. But I've seen a lot, that's not terrible. Like I say, that would be what would be riding, you know, kind of above your belt loop. And like I said, I've seen them like way down here. So not bad. I like the low ride. I like the ones that come up to right here almost even with the top of the sheath. And because I'm a little bit of a full-figured young man. And some of those love handles, some of those that ride down here can kind of go pokey-pokey inside. So that may be a lot more my anatomy than yours, as far as my preference, but that's how I like my side sheaths. Anyway, 11-minute mark and we ain't showed a knife. Here we go, folks. This is what we came to see. I think somebody has added this lanyard on here. And we have a kind of a, well, it ain't kind of a, we have a skull bead on this guy. So I think that is a good size, especially with that lanyard bead there, something to pull it up out of the sheath. That's a nice touch. I'm not much of a skull fan. That is just completely personal preference. Do I see the coolness in it? Yeah, that's cool. A lot of people out there love the skulls and into that. I like the functionality of having this there, whether it's a skull or not. I like that little thing to kind of grip onto and help come out. But let's talk knife. We're not here for the lanyard or the sheath. First of all, we'll go through each blade one by one. As a knife, what do I think? I like it. Blade shape, we have a real kind of flat, a long flat blade here that right at the end has just a little bit of upsweep. Of course, you see the kind of, looks to me like a duck flying. You see the eye there, you see that blade, it kind of looks like, wah, wah. Yeah, anyway, looks kind of like a head of a duck to me, or a flying bird, but that's neither here nor there. Edge on it, could stand sharpening, but how does it work? I am throwing chunks. Look at that, the old sacrificial tent stake out here. Let's find a spot right there. We haven't cut that off. Yeah. Look at that, folks. Pretty deep. And this is a piece of, excuse me, red oak. So this is hardwood. So, oh yeah, that is throwing chunks, folks. So that is a, man, that digs down in really good. So as a whittling, a carving knife or whatever, I dig it. That blade shape is really, I mean, it is really digging in there. Something I am going to notice that I'm going to tell you right off Jump Street, and I'm feeling it, and I'm not digging down, really wrenching, is with this other blade right here, with this open, and this, what is this going to be? This is the gut hook. We'll get to this blade. If you are wrenching down on this knife and really putting some pressure, I am absolutely feeling that blade. Not going to lie to you. Yes, I think this would be a hot spot. It is a hot spot with my hands. I'm not, like I said, when I was doing that, I'm not having to, you know, I'm kind of light whittling. But if I was really torquing down on this, that's a problem. Do not like that ergonomically whatsoever. So, got to give a demerit for that. I wish that was smaller. You see this other blade right here, how it, you see where my finger's at right here, where this guy's laid down. I get it. This is nice and pinchable, what they were going for, but that's too big. I would rather have had like a smaller nail nick or whatever. That is just too much of a hump when you're using the knife. At the end of the day, it has a bunch of other features. You know, you can call this a multi-tool. at the end of the day, you want this. This is a knife first with other accessories. And when I'm using the knife blade of this, I want some form of comfort. And not the move, folks. Not the move for HT. Like the blade. Blade did well. And like I say, this don't have a killer edge on it right now, but it is absolutely wearing out and digging deep into this red oak. So I think that's going to be a fantastic outdoor blade. We are going to fold that in, which, by the way, it folds in. This is a liner lock for this, and it folds in. It would be lefty approved for a left-hand person. But that is something Victorinox with their liner lock knives, they're all what I call left-handed. So a right-handed person is going to have to push back this way to disengage that lock. Not that big a deal. I mean, it's not a deal breaker. I know that's how Victorinox, that's how their liner locks are. I was already adjusted to that. Some of you, that may drive you nuts, and that could possibly be a deal breaker, but I did want to mention it. You don't push it down this way like, you know, a righty would normally do to fold this knife. You have to push it up to disengage the blade. Anyway, we're going to get into this thing right here that was the problem child. And this is a serrated, turn around here, a serrated gut hook. So this, obviously, this knife is kind of geared towards the hunters, opening up field dressing animals, and has a nice no tip right up here where you can get underneath that hide. You guys that field dressed an animal, you know you do not want a real sharp point right there where you're going down into the animal, not to try to get too gross, but you want to get under that skin and unzip that animal, come up. And you don't want to puncture those entrails. You hunters out there know what I'm talking about. And this is a nice feature where you can get up underneath there, get into the blade, and open up that animal. And you don't puncture all the smelly stuff. Because all you hunters know, if you've done that one time, look at there. There's some wood that I threw when I was carving, hit my shoulder. If you do that one time with an animal, you'll know when you did it, and you won't forget that smell. Again, not trying to be too graphic, but this little tip right here, lack of a tip to get up underneath there, that is a good move. The serrations, obviously I'm not cleaning the animal out here, but I see no reason that would not just absolutely unzip some hide. I like it. When you're doing that, again, here's that big hump. This is the main blade now. Now, honestly, I'm just trying to think in my mind, if I was doing that task, how I would be gripping that knife. That is kind of a finesse move. Anyway, folks, when you're going to be using this blade and you're going to be field dressing an animal, you don't have to wrench. You know, this isn't a grip down kind of a deal. So the fact that with the blade closed and this big hump here, not as big a deal using this blade with this big hump. From the main blade up, not as big a deal, but it's still there. Still would have liked to seen them do a different ergonomic choice. That's just me. But when you're using this blade, this isn't that big a deal, because that is not an aggressive bear down high torque kind of usage. You're not going to be doing that when you're using this blade, so that's not going to be come into play as much. Conversely, like I said, when you're using a blade, there is times you have to put some torque, really grip down on your handle, and this guy in that hump would be terrible. So, I like this. I do. Moving on. And also, same thing, it's a liner lock. Got to push it down to disengage it. Last thing on the front, right here in the middle, we have a nice aggressive wood saw. Look at the teeth on that. That joker is mean looking. And let's see if it works. This is my sacrificial tent stake. I probably won't get this on camera. I'm gonna try. Few cuts in. Look at that, folks. We are almost, and this is probably, how thick is that? A good half inch or maybe better that I'm cutting into the tip of this tent stake. And there it went. So, and there's how thick that is. What was that, 10 seconds? Yeah, this is aggressive. And yeah, that was, again, this is red oak. This saw works 100%. And folks, this saw ain't meant to go cut down limbs this big. This saw is meant for this size stuff, maybe a little bigger. And you've seen exactly, if you use the right kind, this is for limbs and branches, folks, let's be real. No problem. No problem. So that is a terrific saw. I co-sign that. That one is just a slip joint. There is no lock for that. And coming around here on the back side, something that I like to see versus a corkscrew, we have the Phillips head. Always like that on my Victorinox. I am not a, when I'm out in the field, I'm not very, I don't go on too many picnics. My wife might say I should do more of it, but we're not opening bottles of bubbly out in the field. I use this Phillips head screwdriver 99 times out of 100 over what I would a corkscrew. So I enjoy, and that had a nice snap too, I enjoy seeing that feature on a back tool. But anyway, folks, we're over 20 minutes. Had a lot to go through here. What do I think about this? And we ain't even talked about star of the show, black and red. So I gotta give it style points. I love the color. Sheath it goes in, I like it. Would have liked to seen a snap there, but this is fine. How does it fit in there? It fits in there absolutely fine. And there's your lanyard. Like I say, you pop this out, it's on your belt, and boom, right out it would go. HT would like to see a snap, personal preference. Don't like the hump. Do not like the hump when I'm using this as a knife. I think it is a hot, it was a hot spot. And of course I didn't get down on it, you know, and wrench, but just by gripping that, I can tell you that any kind of long use, when you're using the blade, you're using this as a knife and you have to torque down on this. No, that's a hard pass for me. So that would eliminate this knife for me. I cannot co-sign this in good faith and say, winner, winner, chicken dinner. This gets HT's two thumbs up. This, folks, is a pass for me. And it is simply ergonomics on the knife blade. Too many metal humps here that are too high and are just, I think it's a poor design when you're using it as a knife. And to me, yes, it's a multi-tool, it has other cool features, but when I use my knife in the field, if I have to pull this out and use this for an extended period of time as a knife, I don't want it to kill my hands after about the first 5 minutes. Cannot give this the HT stamp of approval. I'm sorry. That's my review. I will be reaching out and seeing who we're going to send this on to next. Great saws. The gut hook. Hey, some of the tools on it, they worked flawlessly. Matter of fact, the blade, the tools doing what they do worked flawlessly. I hate the ergonomics. I cannot recommend this as a working tool with the lack of ergonomics and comfortability of this knife. I just cannot. That's my review. God bless you. Sorry it was so long-winded. Anybody, God bless you if you've stuck around this long. We're going to get out of here. See you on the next one. HT out.